horse is an impressive display of strength and a striking example of beauty. Is a historically noble animal, and the nebula that resembles the shape of a horse's head is called the Horsehead Nebula. It's located in the Orion constellation, just a bit south of the Orion's belt star, Alnitak. It's easy to find where it is, however, too hard to watch it visually with an eyepiece and a telescope. Nonetheless, we can watch it perfectly with a camera. These are good news, and that's precisely what we are going to do in a moment. At the distance of around 1500 light years, this iconic dark molecular cloud nebula, catalogued as Barnard 33, was captured by Hubble telescope in infrared light. And as a result, they gifted us with this impressive image. Now, thanks to NASA, ESA, and the Hubble Heritage team, we can see deeper through this interstellar dust cloud, sculptured by stellar winds and radiation. And now, thanks to them, we can not also link the shape of this beautiful nebula with the gorgeous animal, which is the horse, but we also can link their work and determination with the gallant racing horse I've started the video with. Shall we apply the same attitude with our telescopes? Sure! And to receive a bit of motivation,
please subscribe and give it a like!
Let's do it! And we start by using Sharpcap software. And if it's your first time in my channel, I should tell you that this is the best software to do EAA, electronically assisted astronomy, which basically is watching the objects in the sky in real time. As it is the technique I always use to watch the skies, if you need to know more about it, I have loads of videos about this technique in my channel. We are live stacking with 8 second exposures. The setup is a 12-inch F5 Dobsonian telescope and a ZWO AZ294MC camera. With this Dobsonian telescope, we can go deeper than other telescopes with less aperture, but even with a camera with a large sensor, as it is the one that I'm using, we can't get the flame nebula, which is near this one, in the same field of view. Well, actually we can, but with a trade-off. I will show you in a moment. Now we are adjusting the histogram in order to have a better image to watch. And at the end we do a bit of astrophotography to enhance a bit more. Notice that with just 80 seconds of live stacking we have already this beautiful image. This is the Dobsonian power and the power also of the EAA electronically assisted astronomy, with Sharpcap of course. We can also see at the left a beautiful star forming emission and reflection nebula. It's catalogued by the NGC 2023. It has beautiful colors and complex filaments detail. Now we will skip near the end of the live stack, right before we take a snapshot to do some astrophotography. And here we have already 7 minutes of live stacking, watching this gorgeous nebula. And doing a fast astrophotography, just a tweak, look at this beautiful picture. Not only the Horsehead Nebula, but the NGC at the left also. Look at those details. Now, I want to show you how you can frame the flame nebula in the same image. To do this, you will need to use a focal reducer with your camera. However, as you can see, and as I told you before, it has a trade-off. There is massive COMA at the edges of the field of view, and also a bit of vignetting. Those black shadows at the corners. That's why I prefer not to use the focal reducer with this setup, at least most of the time. Nonetheless, it can be used in specific circumstances. Now click on one of these videos on the screen to watch more if you like this kind of content. Thanks for watching.